in hydrogen atom. The spectral series were, that is, the Paschen series. Then, first of all, it was the Lyman series, the Balmer series. Then we come to the Brackett series, Paschen series, and the Fund series. Similarly, these type of series are generated from the target atoms. Now we come towards the K series. This series originate when K electron is knocked out of the atom. Then the electron present in K shell will be given up. The electrons from L, M, N, O. That is the principal quantum number N. That will be 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Shells will jump to K shell. That is N is equal to 1 shell. To fill the vacancy and emit X-ray photon. So this is shown in the figure. That is K alpha. That is L shell electrons are excited and X-rays are generated. Now ejected electron is indicated by an arrow outward, and similarly the other shells are also indicated, from where we will find that K beta and K gamma lines will be emitted. K series is obtained by N is equal to 1 electron transition. 2 to 1 gives K alpha, 3 to 1 transition gives K beta, and 4 to 1 transition, that is when electron jumps from 4th level to 1st level, gives K gamma series or K gamma X-rays. The limiting K line is obtained by infinite to 1 transition. Wavelength of K alpha line is Hc over Ek minus El, where Ek is the energy in K shell and El is the energy of electron in L shell. And then we use a shortcut formula, that is 12,400 angstrom unit divided by Ek minus Ei Ev. So we can compare the values of gamma. That is, gamma is that is greater than gamma k beta, that is gamma k alpha is greater than gamma k beta, and gamma k beta is greater than that is gamma k, that it will be k gamma. So voltage for k alpha, voltage for k beta, and voltage for k gamma, that will be arranged in the, that is, increasing order or in the decreasing order. And we will find the wavelength of the K beta line will be 27 by 32 wavelength of K alpha line. Another point is, when electron jumps from L to K shell, L to K, lower to higher shell, the L shell electron experiences slightly reduced charge, which is due to shielding effect of remaining K shell electron. So effective charge seen by L shell electron is Z minus 1 into E. The frequency of K alpha line from Bohr's theory is EL minus EK divided by H. There we generally write EN2 minus EN1 divided by H. Here we are taking it in terms of shells. So it is EL means energy in L shell, EK means energy in K shell divided by H is equal to RC Z minus 1 whole square, and that is 1 over N1 square minus 1 over N2 square, and this is evaluated as 3 R C over 4, where C is velocity of light and R is Rydberg constant, into Z minus 1, and Z is atomic number. So the relation will become 2.47 10 to the power 15 into Z minus 1 whole square. Lambda K alpha line will be C over mu K alpha line, where K is the number of shell and alpha, that is the wavelength. So it will be reduced to 4 by 3 R into Z minus 1 whole square. And if we further reduce it, it will become 1 to 1 6 angstrom unit divided by Z minus 1 whole square. R is the Rydberg constant, and its value is 1.097 into 10 to the power 7 per meter. The energy of K alpha X-ray photon is energy of K alpha 10.2 into Z minus 1 whole square electron volts. So here energy basically must be calculated in joule, and finally it should be converted to electron volt by using equation 1.6 10 to the power minus 19 joules, or 1 electron volt is 1.6 10 to the power minus 19 joules. L series means one is K series, other is L series. That is principle quantum 2, that is N is equal to 2 series. This originates when an L electron is knocked out of an atom. The electrons from M, N, O shells or quantum number 3, 4, 5 state shells jump to N is equal to 2. That is, all inner electrons jump to N2 shell. L shell to fill the vacancy and emit X-ray photons. L series is obtained by N equivalent to 2 electron transition. When we speak transition, we are referring to that electron is either moving from lower to higher permitted shell or from higher to lower permitted shell. When an electron jumps from lower to higher permitted shell, the atom will exhibit the absorption spectrum, and when it will jump from higher to lower permitted shell, it will exhibit the emission spectrum. So X-ray is a case of emission spectrum. Now the first part is, the second part is, the transition state is 3 to 2. That is, electron will jump from third shell to second shell. It gives L alpha line, 4 to 2 gives L beta line, and 5 to 2 gives L gamma, etc. Now the limiting L line is obtained, the transition from infinity to 2 transition. Lambda L alpha, lambda means wave, that is hc over energy difference of the two shells, that is El minus Em. Now we put the all values in such a way that we may get a rapid calculation. So a shortcut formula is used, that is 12,400 over El minus Em, and that should be angstrom, and the lower portion will be eV. Now wavelength of K alpha line is less than wavelength of L alpha line is less than the wavelength of M alpha line. So frequency of K alpha line is greater than the frequency of L alpha line is greater than the frequency of M alpha line. That is, wavelength and frequency are inversely proportional because energy is given by function h nu or hc over lambda. So nu is always inversely proportional to wavelength. Where wavelength will decrease, the frequency will increase. In this spectrum, the frequency or the wavelength of the lines of the series do not change with accelerating voltage. For different elements, the relative position of the energy levels of various shells are different. So the characteristic X-rays wavelengths depend on the nature of material. The characteristic X-ray spectrum is explained on the basis of Bohr's atomic model. So Bohr's atomic model we have discussed in the atomic structure. That is, Bohr has written 4 postulates of the atomic model, and those postulates we apply in the formation of X-rays. The X-ray spectrum is therefore the continuous spectrum on which the characteristic line spectrum is superimposed. Now here in the figure, we will find that there are 2 peak values are indicated, one for the target as tungsten and other for the target as molybdenum. The target must have high atomic weight, so we find that if the tungsten target is there and the wavelengths, they are varying from 0.3 to about 1 angstrom unit, and there will be relative intensity of the X-ray is increasing, then for tungsten we find that K beta is a lower peak, and for molybdenum it is a higher peak K alpha. So K stands for the quantum number, that is n is equal to 1. So from tungsten, whatever axes are given out, that is called K beta, and from molybdenum, it is given out as K alpha. Now there are certain examples. A potential difference of 20 kilovolts means 20,000 volts is applied across an X-ray tube. Find the minimum wavelength of X-ray generated. So we have to find the wavelength. So what exactly we will do? We will take one equation as EV, other equation as H nu. EV is the energy of electron emitted from cathode, and H nu is the energy of X-rays emitted from target. So EV is equal to H nu or HC over lambda. And from this equation, we will get the value of lambda. Lambda is inverse to frequency. This fact is to be applied during the calculation. So wavelength minimum, that is in a shortcut formula, given as 12,400 angstrom divided by V naught. So 12,400 divided by 20,000, because it is 20 kilovolts. So the wavelength is calculated as 0.62 angstrom units. Now we come towards another example. The wavelength for the K alpha line of an element of atomic number 57 is lambda. So now for K alpha emission, 1 over lambda is proportional to Z minus 1 whole square. So lambda 1 over lambda 2 will be in the inverse ratio Z1 minus 1 whole square divided by Z1 minus 1 whole square.